Well, today marks the end of New Zealand's strictest lockdown laws, with the country allowing many businesses and schools to reopen.
The nation's coronavirus regulations have been some of the toughest in the world, but the jury's still out on whether such extreme measures have done more harm than good. New Zealand's Deputy Prime Minister Winston Peters joins us now from Wellington. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
Did you go too hard?
Look, there'll always be a time for a post-mortem, but when you're facing a crisis, you do the utmost to ensure that you do not leave anything that should be attended to unaddressed, so to speak, and we'll just have to wait the verdict of history. But we went in real hard, real early, to try and get on top of what we still believe is an absolute malignant plague that we have to worldwide to deal with.
And universally praised for it. The great James Hanare famously said, in your country, you have come too far not to go further. You have done too much not to do more. Economically, your government now has real pressures to do more. How will you do that?
Well, the real critical answer questions now for the New Zealand people is, well, we've done so well in combination to get on top of COVID-19, so to speak. Now we have got to rebuild our economy and the same level of cooperation and single-mindedness to build a far more autonomous, explosive, export-led economy of new character with greater wealth for our country is right now at the cusp of our future if we make the right decision and use the same things that got us through, dare I say, the last 5 weeks. Mm. The reality is that New Zealand was never doing well before the COVID attack on our country. And we could do then, and we can do, much better learning from this experience.
I mean, if you look sort of worldwide, I don't think there's any chance we're going to be lifting border restrictions anytime soon. But what about this idea of a trans-Tasman bubble? Have you had any talks with the Australian government about travel and business opportunities between our two countries?
I recognise that idea because it's mine.
So have you spoken to...
You remember that?
That's what we do in Australia. We take your ideas and we make them our own.
we're still your people too.
The Ministry of Foreign Affairs. It came out of a brilliant department called the Ministry of Foreign Affairs in New Zealand by its minister, and it was put to the Aussie media, who then put it to Scott Morrison, who said, well, I've got too much on my program right now. That was last week. Mm. It was always a great idea from my department. It is a serious plan where we go from the known... That is responsible, reliable, trustworthy countries where borders are secure and you can share the borders to expand our economic and tourism base again as fast as we possibly can.
Winston, it's like Russell Crowe, Crowded House, New Zealand. it is a terrific idea, but why can't we progress it further? Because I think both countries are going to need... to develop that relationship even faster now, and why not when we can have a bubble down here?
Look, it always was a good idea that came, as I said, from Ministry of Foreign Affairs and Trade in New Zealand. It is the start early of the rebuild, and we've got no time to waste. I mean, every hour, every day, every week, and every month now is really important. So we've got to start rebuilding with good and sound ideas that have got a permanence and durability about them. And that are not experimental. This is a very sound idea. 55% of our tourism, for example, comes from Australia. So as soon as we can get assured, safe Australian tourism back to New Zealand, then the better.
Well, a good test of this will be the New Zealand Warriors. I mean, they've been granted a federal government exemption to enter Australia to compete in the NRL season. Is it a good thing?
Oh, it's tremendous, actually, and you need better players over there, as you well know. So you've got half the Pacific Islands over there, and half the Maori population, half the island population of New Zealand playing in your league, and then you've got the Warriors. So it all adds to far greater competition, far greater excitement, and you need eight teams, and they're the critical eight team.
I tell you what, fighting words this morning from you, Winston.
No, he's always fighting. It's good news.
We didn't come through this crisis to humbly get off our bed, so to speak, and make some sort of limp-wristed recovery. No, we're back in business.
Well, what about the idea of you becoming another state of Australia? That's very positive, isn't it?
Well, that was a genius idea born of the British. It goes back two centuries. And, of course, most of those ideas go very far.
Winston, it's great to talk to you. Let's hope that your idea...
We're still in your New South Wales constitution. Have the decency to take us out.
No, no. Why would we when we've got the All Blacks coming this way to play for us?
And also,
we need them.
You grabbed your flag 50 years after us. You know, it's confusing, guys. Put a kangaroo on your flag. Go your own way. They got there 50 years before you.
This is
nice.
We've got to come on once a week. This is great stuff, and we'll help build businesses. Best of luck over there, and may we see that idea come to fruition. It's a great idea. Thank you, Winston.
Well, it's great. I mean, they've got a million.
Good luck to Australia, and congratulations to the Australian government, and its people, and its state governments, because they've put it together after the terrible fires early in the year.
Yeah.
It's been a fantastic outcome in Australia, and all the best.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thanks, Winston.